Hello, creatives, and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be doing the next in my Zodiac series. We're going to be illustrating Aquarius. Now, Aquarius is an air element, even though Aquarius is known as the water bearer. And I'm starting with creating the jug for the water bearer, and then I'm going to illustrate the water. I'm going to be using a series of ovals and circles using the spherical tool, which is nested in the shape tool on the toolbar. I decided to do that because it's going to be very fluid. Water is very fluid, and I'm going to continue that theme throughout this, with the exception of the stars and, of course, the constellation. Now, Aquarius, so they are going to be very friendly people. They like to help others. They fight for causes. They're very humanitarian. So we're just going to see how this rolls out. I am making patterns in this one of waves because the symbols, some of the symbols for Aquarius are two wave lines because they are signified by water, even though they are an air element. I'm going to be adding the air element symbol into the A under the Aquarius name on the font that I used. I do end up switching up this font from Myriad Pro to Gabriola just to give it more of a flow. I did start with the water and I added some stars as well as the word Aquarius in there with the air element in the A. You can see that. Aquarius's colors are usually blues and silvers, but their stone is also amethyst. It is their birthstone. So I decided to add these colors into the water coming out of the jug, which I incorporated using the new freeform gradient. I am in love with this new tool because the freeform gradient makes things so easy. It makes everything blend so well. With the stars, I decided to morph them a little bit and change them up just from using your typical star shape tool, which is nested in the shape tools on the left toolbar there. And I made 7 stars because one of the lucky numbers of Aquarius happens to be the number 7. Even though I did bring a star in for the top of the eye for Aquarius, I didn't really count that one technically, but there you go. Now, the colors I used in here are more of an ultramarine blue, electric blue, amethyst, a dark gray, a light silvery gray, and things like that. As you can see here, I put some nice, really light silvery blue as the highlight for the waves. And I also created the constellation for Aquarius. It looks kind of interesting. The actual constellation I made up out of the sphere tool and just the pen tool clicking on each sphere to make the lines. I made that silver just so it stands out, and then I did an outer glow and inner glow effect on it to make the constellation shine and glow. But it kind of looks almost like either a human crawling or an animal to me for the constellation. But regardless, it looks really beautiful and shiny now. I know I did make more of an effort with the water just because the main colors for Aquarius is in the water and it's all about the water for this one. And I am making little tiny tweaks here and there for the colors so that it makes sense as waves because I wanted the water to kind of like reflect and have different dimensions to it. To connect everything together with the water on the jug, I am creating a gradient on the bands that I put on the jug. One is going to reflect with the water and it's going to be a series of the 3 blue colors I used in the water, and the other one is going to just be a gradation between white and dark gray, so it gives the jug more dimension. Because I put a pattern on the actual jug itself, I couldn't necessarily work out putting a gradient on the entire jug, but I thought the bands will give it just enough detail to where it looks more dimensional than if it would be flat, if that makes sense for the color. And for here, I am tidying up the waves symbol I created on the band because I wanted to make it more of a, I wanted to add a gradient to the waves symbol as well, just to add more of that dimension again. And I couldn't do that if all of the shapes that I used for the wave, which are just lines, they're literally just using the line tool. I couldn't do that if they were all disconnected and only grouped together. So what I did is I am tweaking it to where they all line up. Then I used the Pathfinder to combine them all together into one shape. I outlined the stroke and that created it as an actual shape, and then I was able to put the gradient colors in there and put it at an angle so that it matches the angle of the jug so that all the gradients kind of flow together and make sense visually. And that is my illustrated icon for Aquarius. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. Leave me a comment down below of what star sign you are, and I will see you in my next video. See you soon, creatives.